गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक केमिस्ट्री लेसन, द लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, फर्स्ट लेसन. सो इन द लास्ट ईयर, इट मीन्स इन द 8th स्टैंडर्ड, यू लर्न्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज मीन बाय एटम, व्हाट इज मीन बाय एलिमेंट, व्हाट इज मीन बाय मॉलिक्यूल एंड व्हाट इज मीन बाय कंपाउंड, वैलेंसी, वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. जस्ट रिकॉल व्हाट यू लर्न्ड इन द लास्ट ईयर. एटम, atom is the smallest particle of an element. Atom is the smallest particle of an element which may or may not exist, but it will take part in the chemical reaction. Atom is the smallest particle of an element which may or may not exist, but it will take part in the chemical reaction. So that is the definition of the atom. So you know that matter, what is matter? Matter, nothing but which has mass and occupies some space, that is a matter. So each matter is made up of atoms. So atom is a very smallest particle of an element which may or may not exist independently, but will take part in the chemical reaction. So this is the definition about the atom. And the next element, element is a pure substance which is made up of one kind of atoms. So what is the definition of the element? Element is a pure substance which is made up of one kind of atoms, that is called element. So you can give so many examples of the element. So hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, magnesium, sulfur. So these are the examples of the elements. These are the examples of the elements. Nearly 180 elements are there. How many elements? 118 elements are there. 118 elements are there. So element is a pure substance which is made up of one kind of atoms. So nearly 118 elements are there. And the next thing, what is the molecule? Molecule is nothing but it's a set of atoms of the same type together forms a molecule. Set of atoms of the same type together forms a molecule. Molecule of an element. It is a set of atoms, same kind of atoms. It is a set of atoms, same kind of atoms together. They will combine to give the molecule. For example, hydrogen. Two atoms of hydrogen. Hydrogen is made up of two atoms. Same kind of hydrogen gives hydrogen. Similarly, oxygen. Set of atoms. Same kind of atoms combines to give the molecule. So these are the examples of the molecule. Hydrogen, oxygen. Still you can give the examples. And the fourth one, compound. Compound. What is a compound? Compound is formed by combining of two different kind of atoms. Compound is formed by combination of two different kind of atoms. If it formed by same kind of atoms, that is a molecule. It is formed by combining two different kind of atoms, that will give the compound. For example, HCl. Yeah, two different atoms are there. One is hydrogen, another one is a chlorine. So two different atoms combines to give the compound. So magnesium chloride and H2SO4. These are the examples of the compounds. So, and next, move to the valency. Combining capacity of an element. Valency is nothing but element. So we can see variable valencies. Variable valencies, we learned about the variable valencies. So it means one kind of atom have different valencies. For example, iron. Iron, it has ferric and ferrous. So iron has variable valency. One is the ferric, another one is the ferrous. And copper. So copper, it has also variable valency. That is cupric and cuprous. Cuprous. So these are few examples of the elements having variable valencies. So one is iron, ferric and ferrous. Another one is cupric and cuprous. So still we can use the example, lot more example we can give there. And move to the valence electrons. So we learned about the valency. Next topic is valence electrons. Present in the outermost shell, that you will learn in the next coming chapters. Electrons present in the outermost shell, that is called valence electrons. They are involved in the reaction. The electron present in the outermost shell, they are involved in the chemical reactions. They are involved in the chemical reactions, that you will learn in the next coming chapters. Okay, just now move on to the definition. So that is valence electrons. Next, now I will move to the radicals. Yes, radicals. What is a radical? The molecule of a compound is usually made up of two parts. And these parts separately known as radicals. Molecule of a compound is usually made up of two parts. Molecule of a compound is usually made up of two parts, and these parts separately known as radicals. So this is the definition of the radical. Molecule of a compound is usually made up of two parts, and these parts separately known as radical. So this is the definition about the radical. I will explain by taking one example. So I will consider one compound, potassium chloride. So potassium chloride is made up of two parts. So potassium and chloride. So one more example, magnesium chloride or magnesium sulfate. So formula, so potassium chloride formula, KCl. The next topic I will tell you how to write the chemical formula. Just know about the what is the radicals. So one more example, magnesium sulfate, MgSO4. So this is the magnesium sulfate. It is made up of two parts. Magnesium is one radical and sulfate is the another radical. Now move to the, we can see two types of radicals. types of radicals. Types of radicals. You can see two types of radical. One is a simple radical. Simple radical. One is a simple radical. Another one is a compound radical. Compound radical. So you can see two types of radical. One is a simple radical. Another one is a compound radical. What is the simple radical then? Simple radical basically is made up of one kind of atom. That's it. One kind of atom. Only one atom is there. Only one atom is there. Example, Na plus. Sodium. Sodium ion. Sodium ion. So when you are telling radical, if you write only sodium, that is atom. Sodium is atom. Na plus, when you write the sign, then only called as a radical. Otherwise, just be called as a only atom. Now it is a sodium ion. So here only one atom is there. Only one atom is there. That's why it is called for the simple radical. Simple radical. And one more example, Cl minus. Cl minus, because they are already signed on the element, top of the element, Cl minus. So this is also a simple radical. So if you write only Cl, chlorine atom, okay. So that's a Cl minus. To tell is the radical, you should write Cl minus, Na plus. So these are the, and one more, Mg2 plus. So it is also a simple radical because only one atom is there. So these are the examples of the simple radical. And go to the compound radical. What is the compound radical? So simple radical means only one atom is there. So next, compound radical means, so we know the definition of the compound. Compound means two different kind of atoms together combining, then only it will give the compound. Two different kind of atoms combines to give a compound. So similarly, compound radical means two different atoms, a group of atoms combines to give a compound radical. Two different atoms combines to give a radical, compound radical. For example, SO4 2 minus. See that S is one atom, oxygen is one sulfur atom is there, four oxygen atoms is there. So two different atoms here, one is sulfur, another one is oxygen. And one more example, carbonate CO3 2 minus. Okay, SO4 here, carbonate, one carbon atom is there. Three oxygen atoms are there. So this is the example for the compound radical. To tell the radical, you must write the on the element signs should be there. Then what we can tell is a radical. CO3 2 minus. And one more example. Cr2O7 2 minus. Chromate. So this is a chromate. Here two atoms of chromium and seven atoms of oxygen. They will combine to give a compound radical. So compound radical is set of different kind of atoms together combines to give the compound radical. So SO4 2 minus, CO3 2 minus, Cr2O7 2 minus. So these are the few examples of the compound radical. So you can see two types of radical, simple radical and compound radical. Then move to the next. So as we know that when acid reacts with the base, what will it give when acid reacts with the base? Base plus acid gives like so. When acid reacts with base, it will give salt and water. You know that? You learned So you use salt plus water. You use salt plus water. An acid reaction where you use salt plus water. And now I will take one example. So for a base, I will take KOH. So KOH, potassium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide is a base. Okay. Next, acid. HCl, hydrochloric acid, hydrochloric acid. When these two react, it will give. So what it will give? Salt. So what is your product there? So KCl. KCl. KCl plus H2O. KCl plus H2O. KCl plus H2O. So when the base reacts with the acid, it will give salt. For example, potassium hydroxide reacts with the hydrochloric acid. Will give salt and water. Salt, water. Why I am telling this one? Yes, I am coming to that point now. So, potassium is coming from the base, is it? Potassium is coming from the base. So, potassium is coming from the base. In potassium hydroxide, you can see that. So, you can see the salt, potassium chloride. Potassium chloride. So, potassium is coming from the base. Potassium is coming from the base, that's why it is called as the basic radical. So potassium chloride, potassium chloride, potassium is coming from the base, that's why potassium is called basic radical. In potassium chloride, potassium is coming from the base. Potassium is called basic radical. So potassium is called basic radical. This is very important, keep it in mind there. So potassium is coming from the base. You said potassium is coming from the base. So that's why potassium is called basic radical. And so in potassium chloride, he is coming from the acid, is coming from the acid. HCl is coming from the acid. So chloride is called acid radical. Acid radical. Okay, keep in mind that. So chloride is coming from the acid. That's why it's called as acid radical. And one more name is there for basic radical. Basic radical, that is an electropositive radical. So basic radical is also called electropositive radical. Basic radical is also called electropositive radical are called cations. What do you call? Cations. So basic radical is also called electropositive radical are cations. Why am I telling it's a cation? Well, these potassium chloride is, if you do electrolysis for potassium chloride, it is split as K plus and Cl minus. When potassium chloride is, if you do electrolysis, so it is split as K plus and Cl minus. That's why the basic radical is also called electropositive radicals. Look at that. So potassium is a basic radical. On the top, element the top sign is a positive sign is there. That's why it is called electropositive. And Cl minus. So Cl minus chloride is an acid radical. That is called electronegative radical. So chloride, so acid, chloride is acid radical, that is chloride, red blanket, chloride, acid radical, that is a chloride. So it is also called, electronegative radical. What is called? Electronegative radical. It is also called electronegative radical or anion. So potassium, K plus is a cation and Cl minus, that is an anion. K plus and Cl minus. Okay. So this is about the radicals. This is about the radicals. Next. How to write the chemical formula? So this method is also called crisscross method. So method is also called crisscross method. Crisscross method. So this is a crisscross method. So method is also called crisscross method. So first I will consider one compound. Magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride. So first I will tell you how to write the formula of magnesium chloride. So first thing, first you should write the symbol of the radicals. Here you can, as I told, so radical is a, it is made up of two parts. So one is the acid radical, another one is the basic radical. So magnesium chloride is a, it is made up of two radicals. It is made up by, these compound is made up by two radicals. So separately you should write the symbol. First you should write always basic radical. So basic radical, so it means magnesium here is the basic radical. Magnesium is the basic radical. Chloride is the acid radical. So write the symbol of the magnesium and chloride. Magnesium, Mg, chloride, Cl. So first write the symbols of the radicals. First, always you should write basic radical first. Then it is followed by the acidic radical. This is the first step. Okay, and the next thing, you should write the valency on the top of the element. Valency of these elements. So valency of the elements, you should write on the top of the element. So magnesium, its valency is 2 plus. And chlorine is 1 minus. So its valency is 1 minus. So magnesium is, will comes in the second period. That you will learn in the next chapter, how to find the valencies. Okay, so magnesium, just I am telling you now how comes value 2. So magnesium will comes in the second group. Nearly there are 18 groups are there in the periodic table. You can see there. You can look at this periodic table. This is the periodic table. Okay, so there are 18 groups are there. These vertical columns is there now. Vertical, that is called groups. Okay, then horizontal row is there now. Horizontal, that is called periods. Okay, vertical columns, they are called groups, and horizontal rows, they are called periods. Okay, that you learned in the fifth chapter, periodic table chapter. Just why I am telling, because this magnesium will come in the second group. Look at that. So this is the first group. This is the second group. Its valency is 2. If you take any element from the second group, its valency is 2. So if the element comes from the first group, its valency is 1. Okay. So if any element comes from the first group, its valency 1 only. Okay. So magnesium, if it comes in the second group, okay, its valency 2. And chlorine, you can see in the 17th group. Look at that. last second column. So this is the last second column, chlorine. So its valence is 1. Its valence is 1. That's why I am writing 1 minus. So 1 minus. 1 minus why? Because so chloride is an anion. Chloride is an anion. Negative charge should be there. Negative charge should be there. And magnesium is a positive, electropositive radical. Electropositive radical. That's why 2 plus. 2 plus minus. 1 minus why? Because so chloride is an anion. Chloride is an anion. Negative charge should be there. Negative charge should be there. And magnesium is a positive, electropositive radical. Electropositive radical. That's why 2 plus. 2 plus. And next, so this is the first step. First step, the first step you will write the symbols of the elements. Second step, you will write the series. Valency, you will write the valency. And in the next step, so in the next step, you should ignore the signs. Ignore the signs. While writing the chemical formula, you should ignore the signs. So Mg2 plus. So one you should write Mg2. Okay? And Cl minus is there now. What you should write? Cl1. Now ignore the signs while writing the chemical formula. Now what is the next step? You should do the cross multiplication of their valencies. It means magnesium will go to the magnesium valency will go to the chlorine are on the right side. Below right side here will come. And chlorine valency will come to the right side of the magnesium. Below right side of the magnesium. It means you can try to do the cross multiplication of the valencies. So this one will go to the magnesium, right of the magnesium, below the right of the magnesium. So it means Mg1. So the magnesium valency will come to the right side of the Cl, below right side of the chlorine. So Cl2. No? So if 1 is there, we can rub that 1. No number is there, means it is 1 only. If no number is there, means it is, we consider as 1 only. Now it's magnesium chloride formula. What is the magnesium chloride formula? MgCl2. So this is the formula of the magnesium chloride. This is the formula of the magnesium chloride. Just I will recall it. Once again, I will explain that one more in chemical formula. The first term, magnesium chloride. So this is the compound name. And magnesium, first always you should write the basic radical. First, magnesium is the basic radical. Chloride is the acidic radical. Magnesium. So write the symbol. Magnesium. So magnesium symbol is Mg and chlorine symbol is Cl. Okay. Then in the next step, you should write the valencies of the elements on the top of the element. On the top of the element. Don't write here. Okay. Write on the top of the element. Okay. Don't write here also. To the side or to the left side. Here only you should write. Top of the element. Okay. Here also. Similar to Cl minus. What minus? Cl minus. Okay. Next, in the next step, we will ignore these signs. So these signs will be ignored when writing the chemical formula. Okay. So, cancel out these signs. And next thing, you should do the cross multiplication of their valencies. Cross multiplication of their valencies. So, this is the valency. Magnesium valency 2, chlorine valency 1. Okay, then you have to do the cross multiplication. If you do the cross multiplication, that will 2, where magnesium valency will go to the right side of the chlorine, below the chlorine. Okay, to the right side of the chlorine, right here. Okay, like that. Similarly, chlorine valency will come to the below the magnesium right side. Below the magnesium right side. Then further become MgCl2, magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride. We will take one more example. Calcium oxide. So this is the first one. And second one now. Calcium oxide. Calcium oxide. So here calcium is a positive radical. It means it is a basic radical. Basic radical. Then oxide is a acidic radical. Oxide is a acidic radical. So first you should write the symbol of the basic radical. Calcium. Ca. Calcium. So calcium symbol is Ca. Oxide means O. Okay. Oxygen. Okay. Next. Now we should write the valency. should write the valency. So calcium valency is 2. Calcium valency is 2. So why its valency is 2? It is also coming from the second group. It is also coming from the second group, calcium. Okay, second group. So its valency 2 plus, because it is a cation and oxygen. So its valency 2 minus oxygen. Where is oxygen family? Here. So look at that. 16th group. So 16th group, its valency is always 2 only. Oxygen, sulfur, silicon, tellurium, so polonium. So it is a 16th group, its valency is 2. Okay. Oxygen is coming from the 16th group. So oxygen valency is 2. So that's why radical 2 minus, it is an anion. Acidic radical, that is an electronegative radical, anion. Okay. Now what is the next step? Now here, look at that. So 2 is the HCl. So 2 is the common. 2 is the common. So we can cancel out that one. If same numbers are there, we can cancel out that one. So 1 will be remaining. Ca 1 plus. So O 1 minus. O 1 minus. Now calculate the size. Now I am taking HCl. Here 2 is the common factor. That's why I am cancel out. Because here also valency 2. Here also valency 2. If valencies are same, we can cancel out that one. Okay, so next up, neglect the size. Neglect the sign. C A O. Now here one is remaining there. Now what is the next step? Do the cross multiplication. So it means formula is C A O. C A O. Calcium oxide. Calcium oxide. So this is the formula of the calcium oxide. Okay, and one more, we'll do that. Sodium chloride. The last one it is aluminium. Aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride. So first write the symbol of the basic radical. Aluminium Al, chloride Cl. Next you should write the valency. Aluminium. Aluminium. So here, so it comes in the 312 boron family. So here, 13th group. You can see the, so boron, aluminium, gallium. Here is aluminium will come there. So here, its valency is 3. Its valency is 3. Now that's why I will write 3 plus. So it's a cation. Positive sign you should write there. And Cl minus. We already learned that. 1 minus. Then what is the next step? Next step is we have to neglect the size. We have to cancel out that one. Al 3, Cl 1. Al 3, Cl 1. So next step, what is the next step? You have to do the cross multiplication of the valencies. Valency. Do the cross multiplication. This valency of aluminum, go to the Cl on the right side, below the Cl on the right side. Cl, so aluminium. So now formula is AlCl3. AlCl3. Aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride. So this is formula of the aluminium chloride. So this is the method to write the chemical formula. This is the method to write the chemical formula. And few example, few homework I'll give, you can do it in the home. Aluminium hydroxide. I will write here. Try this in home. Aluminium hydroxide and potassium bromide. Potassium bromide and one more. HCl, hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric एसिड एसिड सो एल्युमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड पोटेशियम ब्रोमाइड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड सो राइट द केमिकल फार्मूला ऑफ दीस कंपाउंड्स केमिकल फार्मूला ऑफ दीस कंपाउंड्स ओके सो विल कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट
रिकॉल व्हाट यू लर्नड इन दिस क्लास ओके सो फर्स्ट सो आई टोल्ड दैट व्हाट यू बाय एटम एटम इज द स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल ऑफ एन एलिमेंट which may or may not exist but it will take part in the chemical reaction that is the atom next thing element element is a pure substance which is made up by similar kind of atom one kind of atoms so element is a pure substance which is made up by one kind of atoms molecule it is made up by same kind of atoms for example hydrogen H2 oxygen O2 So these are the molecules. Okay, molecule of a element. And the next is compound. Compound is so it is made up by two different kind of atom. That is a compound. And next we learned about the radicals. So radicals, molecule of a compound which is made up by two parts. And these parts separately called radicals. And these parts separately called radicals. For example, potassium bromide. So potassium bromide. Potassium is one radical. Bromide is another radical. Then we can see two types of the radical. One is a simple radical. Another one is a compound radical. So in simple radical, so only it is one type of one atom is there. So Na plus, Cl minus, K plus. One type of only one atom is there. So that is a simple radical. And compound radical. Compound radical it is made up of different kind of atoms two different kind of group of atoms combines to give the compound radical for example sulfate SO4 2 minus carbonate CO3 2 minus CO3 2 minus and so in potassium chloride that is called basic radical and chloride is the acidic radical so basic radical is also called electropositive radical Whereas acidic radical that is also called electronegative radical. So electropositive radical is also called cations and electronegative radical is also called anion. Okay. So this is about the radicals. Then chemical formula I told there how that is method is also called criss-cross method. So first we will write the symbols of the element. First always you write the basic radical, then it is followed by the acidic radical. So first you will write the symbols, then what is the next step? Then you will write the valencies of the element on the top of the element. Then we will write the then in the next step you will cancel out the signs while writing the chemical formula. There is no need of signs. Okay. Sign will cancel then and next step we will cross multiply the valencies. So this is what you learn from this class. Okay, thank you one and all.